popular article which is published in the journal Electronics. And as you can see, as the year increases, the number of this is the number of component number of component per integrated circuit, it also increases. And this is the your the figure B. It shows that when the large number of components are present, then at that time relative your manufacturing cost also reduces. But in the year of 1975, Moore again once revised his prediction, and he announced that the density of electrons on a chip must be doubled by every 18 months instead of the your 24 months. See, like this, this is the one figure. See, this shows the number of transistor per microprocessor, and this is the prediction up to 2020. See, like this, you can observe from this figure that in the around of 2010, the FinFET technology, it got more prominent, means it is more advantageous. Like the high K gate insulator also, it is more advantageous in the era, because it can overcome whatever the problems are there in the conventional MOSFET. Like the, you can use the various channel material. Normally we are using the channel material group 4 semiconductor, but if you are using the high mobility group 5 or group 3 semiconductor or the germanium, because of having the high mobility, it is more faster, and as a result there will be more current in the flow, and you can use this 3-5 or the group 3-5 group semiconductor as the channel material, or germanium as the channel material. See, next we'll discuss what is this ITRS. ITRS, which is full form of the ITRS, is your International Technology Roadmap for Semiconductor, which is nowadays known as IRDS, International Roadmap for Devices and System. Nowadays the ITRS, it is renamed as IRDS, International Roadmap for Devices and System. See, it has the main three contribution. What it will do, it will identify the essential requirement of the current technology node. See, as the technology node is going out, what is the current requirement? Like how much, what is the requirement of the on current or the off current or the threshold voltage or some other parameter, that means the supply voltage. It identifies those requirements. Then it points out the solution to the problem and the limitation in the present time. Suppose what are the problems are there in the current technology node or various novel devices, if there is some limitation, then it will find out those limitation of the problem in the present scenario. Like this, it finds out the area where no manufacturing solution exists and invites the industry and the academics to do the research in those areas. Suppose what are the limitations are there in the current technology node or current some novel devices, then it invites the industry as well as the academics to do the research so that those problems can be overcome. See, this figure four shows the plot between size versus area. As you can see, as the year increases, the feature size also reduces, along with the gate length of the devices also reducing. Due to this, because the as we are scaling down the devices, then the gate length of the devices also reduces, as well as the feature size of the devices also reduces. That means this plot shows the feature size, which is the function of the time. See, like this, next we'll give the view of the technology node. The technology node, as you can see, as the year 2003, the technology node is 22 19 nanometer. Like 2005 0 is your 65 nanometer. Similarly, like this in 2009 32, like this 22 nanometer in 2011. Even nowadays the 7 nanometer or the 10 nanometer technology node also used. See, but this technology node doesn't define arbitrary. There is some logic. As we know, according to the Moore's law, we have to reduce the device dimension so that a number of transistors must be doubled by every 18 months. So like this, if you want to need the number of transistors double, then what you have to do, you have to reduce the area. How you can reduce the area by half? If you multiply both the length, suppose this is the length of the device is here, whatever the length was there, you multiply length by 1 by root 2. Similarly, you multiply width by also 1 by root 2. Cp multiply both length and the width by 1 by root 2. Then the ultimately your area will be simply half. Area will be simply half. See, like this, the technology node also defined like this. Suppose the in 2003, the technology node is 90 nanometer. If you multiply 90 by simply 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2 means simply your
Dear participants, I think there is a network issue with the speaker. He will get back to you once we resume the session as soon as possible. Please wait. Dear participants, due to electrical problem, their electrical connection has been disconnected in the speaker set side. So due to that, he got disconnected. I talked to him. He will join shortly within 1 to 2 minutes. So please be patient.
Hello. Yes, sorry for the disturbance.
Hello. It's okay. You can continue with your session.
Yes. See, like this, the whatever we have discussed the technology node, as you can see in the 2003, the node is 90 nanometer. Like this, 2005 is the 65 nanometer technology node. So like this, in the year of 2011, it is your 22 nanometer technology node. Even nowadays, the 10 nanometer or the 7 nanometer node are used. As you can see, this is the corresponding, as you have to reduce the area by half, that means you have to reduce both the width as well as the length of the device by 1 by root 2. That means accordingly, you have to multiply the technology node. This one we have derived it like this. Whatever the node is there, suppose in the 2003, it is 90 technology node. Then if you multiply it is by simply 1 by root 2, then you will get the next node will be 65 nanometer node. So like this, in the year of 2009, the node is 32. If you multiply by your 1 by root 2, then we will get the next node is your 22 technology nanometer node. As you can see, this technology node doesn't mean that your channel length. It is simply the whatever the along with the your decreasing along with the scaling of the technology node, there is the reduction in the channel length also. But it doesn't mean that the channel length is equal to simply the technology node. So the technology node means what? Simply the your distance between the metal line. In the when you fabricate the device, there will be some metal line between the two device, and the distance between those two metal contact is called the techno pitch, and the half of this pitch is called the technology node. And as you can see, these are the various application in the year of 2003 for 90 nanometer technology node. These are the various area, the SiG or the PMOS like this. Nowadays, in the year of 2011, this non-planar tri-gate architecture, that is the FinFET architecture, these are more prominent. Like this, in the year of 2015 to 19, the 3-5 semiconductor device, these are the prominent research area. Similarly, the carbon nanotube or the nanowire prototype research, these are the various promising area in the year of 2015 to 19. See, next we'll discuss the advantage of scaling. See the scaling, because this is a very important parameter for semiconductor devices. See, in order to improve the device performance, we have to do the scaling of the devices. Because if we do the scaling of the device, the speed of the device increases. See that normally we know the MOSFET. In the MOSFET, whatever the on current is there, the drain current is directly proportional to the length by width. If we do the scaling of the W by L ratio, if we do the scaling of the device, the on current also increases. And if the on current increases, accordingly the speed of the device also increases. Similarly, if we perform the, as you know, along with the scaling, the device dimension reduces. That means in the same area, we can accommodate more number of devices on a chip. That means the packing density also increases. The better packing density can be obtained with the scaling of the devices. Then accordingly, like this, that means it leads to the reduction in the cost per function also. Because within the same area, because the increase in the packing density leads to the your reduction in the cost per function also. And with the scaling, the dynamic as well as static power consumption also reduces. Because along with the, you can reduce the your whatever the power consumption is there, dynamic as well as the static power consumption can also be scaling of the semiconductor devices. See, this is the very popular table. You may know, as you can see, that whatever the there are mainly two types of scaling. One is the constant field scaling, another one is the constant voltage scaling. As you can see, in the constant field, constant what voltage scaling, whatever the your it is there. See, in the constant voltage scaling, this voltage, it is not scalable, it is simply one only. Okay, see, like this, the in the constant field scaling, this electric field also not scalable. As you can see, if you the whatever the length and the width or the FJ means the your junction depth or the oxide thickness, this all are scaled by 1 by 2. Similarly, in the constant voltage scaling also, it is scaled by 1 by k, where k is the scaling factor. Like this, this is the generalized scaling. Like this, or other parameter, your doping concentration of the your source and the drain or the channel channel. This also scaled by k in the constant field scaling, and in the constant voltage scaling, scaled by k squared. And the generalized one is your alpha k. But this VDD, it is not scaled in the your in the constant voltage scaling. However, in the constant field scaling, it is scaled by 1 by k. And this is the your derived scaling behavior of the transistor. Whatever the your drain current and the capacitance or the electric field is there, the drain current, it is scaled by 1 by k in case of the field scaling. However, in case of the voltage scaling, it is scaled by k. Like this, these are the derived scaling behavior of the circuit. These are the related to the circuit parameter, the delay power and the power delay product and the your circuit density. As you can see, the delay, it is reduced by 1 by k. However, in constant voltage scaling, it is reduced by 1 by k square. Similarly, power also reduced by 1 by k square. And in the constant voltage scaling, it is scaled by k. Like this, the power delay product, this product only, it is scaled by 1 by k cube, 1 by k into 1 by k square, we will get 1 by k cube. Like this, 1 by k square into k, we will get 1 by k. And the circuit density, it is scaled by k square and the k square in both your constant field scaling and the constant voltage scaling. See, next, we will discuss some limitation of the scaling. So the scaling, whatever we discuss when we discuss the MOSFET PPT, see, then at that time, we already informed that the scaling, it leads to the various short channel effect. See, whatever the short channel effect, like the drain induced barrier lowering, as you scale the device, the whatever the your depletion which is there between the source channel and the drain channel, they come very close to each other, and it leads to the various short channel effect, like high your subthreshold swing or DIBL or your reduction in the on-top current ratio. Then this subthreshold swing also limited to the your 60 millivolt per day. See the what is the subthreshold swing? See the subthreshold swing means what? The amount of gate voltage to reduce the drain current by one order of magnitude. See, suppose this is one ID versus VG characteristic. This is one ID versus your VG characteristic for any MOSFET in the log scale. And suppose this is the current, this current is your 10 to the minus 10, and this current is your 10 to the power minus 9. Then how much gate voltage is required to reduce the drain current from 10 to the minus 2, 10 to the minus 10? That means one order of magnitude from 10 to the minus 9 to 10 to the power minus 10. How much gate voltage is required? That is called the amount of gate voltage required to reduce the drain current by one order of magnitude is called the subthreshold swing. See, this is the in case of the, that means if the value is very low, then we will get the very good switching performance. That means it can easily turn on or the turn off the device. We can easily turn it on or we can switch off the device. But in case of the conventional MOSFET, it is seen that the subthreshold swing is limited to the 60 millivolt per decade, but this is at the 300 Kelvin, at temperature of the 300 Kelvin. That means it is more difficult to turn off the device, and the noise margin also reduces. And one of the another limitation is there, op current also increases by at the rate of 10x for each CMOS technology node. See, as we know, if we reduce the length, then along with the on current increases, but the off current also increases along with the scaling of the channel length. And this, that means if such type of behavior we got, that means it has some leakage current also. And if this such device cannot be applicable or suitable for the low power application. See, this table shows that how the your along with the technology node, the scaling of the VDD is also achieved. As you can see, as we going from 90 nanometer to the 45 nanometer, at the 90 nanometer, the supply voltage is simply 1.2 volt. At the 45 nanometer, this is your 1 volt. That means along with that, your scaling of the supply voltage, along with that scaling of the your technology node, the supply voltage also reduces. Then why we move to the your emerging device? See, as you have observed, we need to achieve the certain circuit speed or to maintain the constant power density, both the supply voltage and the threshold voltage of the integrated circuit is reduced along with the device dimension. Your threshold voltage also reduces, as well as your supply voltage also reduces. And to reduce the off current and the power delay product, we have to reduce the off current, as you have seen, along with the length scaling of the channel length, the off current degrade. In order to reduce the off current, we need the emerging devices, or to reduce the power delay product. So the gate length can be scaled but does not affect the current, unlike the conventional device. The conventional device, it is seen that along with the length scaling, your op current or the current parameter got affected. But in order to overcome this, we need the emerging device. And it is also seen that the sub-threshold swing, it is limited to the 60 millivolt per TP. But if you use the tip head, the tunnel head, then the tunnel head operation, due to the tunnel head, it operates on the band-to-band tunneling. We'll discuss in details this point also. The tunnel head, it operates on the band-to-band tunneling. However, the MOSFET, it operates on the your thermionic emission. Due to this band-to-band tunneling, the tunnel head, the switching performance is very fast. And as a result, the sub-threshold swing also less than 60 millivolt per decade. Similarly, why we have to move to the emerging device? Because we need the high on-to-off current ratio. And due to low off current, leakage current can be reduced and improves your energy efficiency. If you reduce your off current, then the leakage current as well can be reduced, and we can improve the energy efficiency of the device. And to reduce the short channel effect, whatever the short channel effect we have observed, like high SS or the DIBL, in order to overcome those barriers, we have to move to the emerging devices. Then whatever just now we have discussed, the similar thing is mentioned for introduction to the emerging device. That means a device which steep sub-threshold slope, like your SS value less than 60 millivolt per decade, or very good switching performance. Then high on current at reduced supply. That means along with the scaling of the technology node, it must give the your high on current. Then high on to off current ratio, and the unidirectional conduction can be explored to reduce the power loss. See, next, we'll discuss the novel device like the FinFET and the tunnel FET. See, first we'll discuss the FinFET. See, why we need the FinFET? Because as we have seen, to follow the Moore's law, we have to increase the number of transistors. But along with the, as we have discussed, the as we scaling down the dimension, that means transistor dimension, it results in various short channel effects like high SS, high DIBL, like this. In order to overcome those things, the FinFET is one of the favorable device because it can control the gate over the channel from all over the channel. Because the FinFET, it is the 3D structure. What it can do, it can control the channel from all side of the gate, and that's what it is one of the favorable device. And the Chen Ming Hu, the year of 19, wait for a minute. Hello. See, the Chen Ming Hu and his group in the year of 1988. The Chen Ming Hu and his group in the year of 1988 first proposed this term FinFET, because the structure of the FinFET looks like a pin. That's what the name is, your FinFET. And the figure 5, it shows the difference between the single gate and the double gate operation, the short channel effect. As you can see, The double gate means the FinFET structure, and the single gate means the simple MOSFET structure. The red color indicates the the single gate, and the blue color indicates the double gate. As you can see, the both the DIBL as well as the subthreshold swing is very low in case of the double gate device compared to the single gate devices. That's why the FinFET is the favorable device in compared to the your conventional MOS devices. See, next, this is the structure. The structural difference between the FinFET and the your MOSFET. See the this figure 6A, it represents the planar MOSFET. It is the one of the popular structure. I think all of you may know. See, and this figure 6B, it is the FinFET structure. So in case of the FinFET, the channel, whatever channel is, it is the vertical. However, the MOSFET, the channel is the horizontal. Channel is the horizontal in case of the MOSFET. And the conducting channel is wrapped by thin oxide. The, in this case, you can see the whatever the channel is there, this is the your pin. This is the pin. This is the pin. Here, source is there and drain is there. And in between this, below this oxide, the channel region is there. And whatever the conducting channel is there, it is wrapped by oxide. This is the your gate dielectric material. It is wrapped by the oxide. And the gate, whatever the gate is there, it is placed at right angle. As you can see, these are the one gate material. This is also one gate material. It is placed at right angle and it wraps over the whole pin. You can see the your gate is placed over the whole pin. That means this is the structural difference between the your FinFET and the MOSFET. The FinFET, the channel is simply the vertical. However, the MOSFET is horizontal. And in this case, the gate area is more. In this case, in case of the FinFET, the gate area is more. See, when the gate area is more, then we can expect that the gate control over the channel. As you know, the your device behavior depends upon the your control over the channel. In case of the MOSFET, only one gate material is there. Only the gate area is very low compared to the FinFET. That it will give some better result or better behavior electrical characteristics, or it can control the your short channel parameter compared to the MOSFET. The working principle of the FinFET is similar to the MOSFET. See that it also works on the thermoionic emission only. And like the MOSFET, in this case also, if you apply some low gate voltage, then only weak inversion, that means depletion charge will be there. However, by applying some large gate voltage or by applying the potential between source to drain, then there will be the device will be in strong inversion region, and that whatever the p-type channel is there, it becomes the n-type. See, like this, the your FinFET, it can be your n FinFET or the p FinFET. Like the MOSFET, in case of the your n FinFET, the source and the drain, those are the n plus, and the channel is the p-type. Sorry. And by applying the appropriate gate voltage, we can invert the your p-type semiconductor to the n-type semiconductor. However, the width of the FinFET, the whatever the device is, the FinFET, the width is given by simply 2 into height of the pin plus your TSI. So TSI means what? This thickness, whatever the thickness is there, TSI, this is the your, the thickness of the pin is called your TSI. And H pin is what? H pin is the height of the pin. The total width is gained by 2 into height of the pin plus your TSI. See, the whatever I just told, the working principle is similar to the MOSFET. A small gate voltage, a depletion region will be formed. And at high gate voltage, the semiconductor surface is inverted from P to N type, and applying the source voltage between the your source and the drain terminal, the current will be flow from source to drain. See, next we'll discuss the types of the FinFET. See, this is the figure 7A and the B. This shows the your structure, the double gate FinFET and the triple gate FinFET. See how it becomes a double gate and the triple gate. See, whatever the oxide thickness is there, as you can see, this oxide thickness at the top gate, there are mainly two gates. Suppose this is the front gate, this is the back gate, and this is the top gate. The whatever the oxide thickness is there for the top gate, it is very large. It is very large compared to the front and the back gate. As you know, the what is the your capacitance? Capacitance is what? Simply epsilon by T ox. epsilon by what T ox. That means if this oxide thickness is very large, that means your gate control over the channel reduces in case of your double gate. In case of the double gate, that's what it acts with the double gate, because in this case only this gate one and gate two will have the impact on the your channel. That means it will it has the impact on for the your for gate one and the gate two. And because of this high gate oxide thickness, this top gate, it does not have an influence on the channel characteristics. That's why it is your double gate. However, in case of the triple gate, this, as you can see, whatever the oxide thickness is there, this oxide thickness is uniform over the whole pin. That means in this case, this gate 3, whatever the top gate is there, it also has effect on the electrical characteristics of the pin pair. That's what it is your triple gate. That's what it is your triple gate device. That's what it is your triple gate device, because in this case, the top gate, it also has the impact on the electrical characteristics. Like this, it depending upon this oxide thickness of the top gate, it can behave as the double gate or the triple gate pin plate. See, next, the structural comparison is the HG and the IG. See, the HG means the shorted gate and IG means the independent gate. See, the shorted gate means short. See, in this case, as you can see, the same gate material is used over the whole pin. The same gate material is used over the whole pin. That means we have shorted both the gate one and the gate two by using some your gate material. We have shorted the your gate one and the gate two by using some your gate material. That's what it is your shorted gate pin plate. However, how if we is in the your figure 8b, by using the dielectric material, what we have done? See, in the figure B, by using the dielectric material, we have isolated the gate one and the gate five. We have isolated the gate one and the gate five. That's what it is your independent gate pin pair. Similarly, the figure 9b, this is your symmetric gate and the asymmetric gate pin pair. HG, in this case, HG means what? HG means your shorted. HG means is a shorted, and in this case, HG means is your simply the symmetric gate and the asymmetric gate. As you can see, depending upon the work function also, in this case, the wait for a minute. Ajay, phone korte chho Ajay. See, in case of this symmetric gate, as you can see, the work function of the both the gate one and the gate two are same. See, from the figure, it is something this color, the color of the gate two is something different compared to the gate one. That's why the work function of this gate two is different compared to the your gate one. The work function value of the gate one and the gate two are different in case of the your figure 9b. That's why this is an asymmetric gate pin pair. However, in case of the 9a, the work function of the your gate one and the gate two are same. That's why this is your symmetric. That's why this is a symmetric gate pin pair. That means depending upon the work function value, it can behave as your symmetric or the asymmetric gate pin pair. And these are the Chen Ming Hu, who is the IEEE medal owner. He is the father of the pin pair. And pin pair, it is the result of the one sponsored project by DARPA, Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, by US government. And his first job as the tutor for high school students, and later he becomes the assistant professor at MIT. See, this all about the your basic introduction of the pin pair. See, next we'll discuss the tunnel pair. See, the tunnel pair, as we know, the tunnel pair operation is different compared to the your pin pair. The tunnel pair, it is simply the your reverse bias P ion structure. In this case, this P is your source, P plus is your source, and the N is your drain, and channel is simply intrinsic material. Whatever the channel is there, it is simply intrinsic material, and it works on the principle of the inter-vein tunneling. And it can be your P-MOS type or the N-MOS type device. In case of the this is whatever the structure in figure 10 is shown, it is a simply your end fin, end tunnel fed. In the your pre tunnel fed, the your type of the material of the source and the drain are different. And the figure 11 which shows the operation of the tunnel fed at the on and the off condition. So in this case, the black color indicates the your off condition and the your red color indicates the on condition of the tunnel fed. However, the drain to source voltage is fixed at 0.5 volt. When gate voltage is equal to 0 volt, it is just simply the off state, and the off on state is what? The gate voltage is equal to 1.5 volt. And this junction, the tunnel fed, it operates on the tunnel junction operation. That means the tunnel junction is the junction between the source and the channel. And this is the energy band diagram shows that at the on condition, this tunnel width, whatever the width is there, the tunnel width at the tunnel junction is very low. As a result, electrons from the valence band of the source can easily tunnel to the conduction band of the channel, and we will get the current. However, in case of the off state, as you can see, this tunnel width, the black color, the tunnel width is very large. That's what due to having this large tunnel width, electrons cannot easily tunnel through this barrier or tunnel through this width. And as a result, the tunnel fed, it has very low off current compared to the your other MOSFET or the FinFET also. See, this is the your operation between the tunnel fed and the FinFET. The low leakage current due to the reverse bias junction, and in this case, high leakage current due to the harmonic emission. The substation swing is 60 millivolt. You can achieve 60 millivolt per degree, even less than 60 millivolt per degree also. And in this case, it is limited to the 60 millivolt per degree. And downscaling degrades the device performance in case of the MOSFET. However, the tunnel fed, the device performance does not degrade with the scaling also. And these are the disadvantages. Using the reverse bias PIN body, the one of the disadvantages is what? The low on current, because it is the reverse bias device. Due to this reverse bias, the on current is very low compared to the MOSFET or the FinFET also. But in this case, the on current is very large, and the gate to drain capacitance is dominant in case of the tunnel fed. However, gate to drain capacitance is almost equal to the gate to source capacitance in case of the your MOSFET. See, this is the difference between the tunnel fed and the MOSFET, and this is the same thing is shown in the picture. This is the one NMOS, this is the one NTFET. As you can see, it operates on the harmonic emission. If you apply the gate bias, this barrier width reduces in case of the MOSFET, and these carriers can flow from source to the drain. However, in case of the your tunnel fed, it operates in the tunneling operation, and by applying the appropriate gate voltage, it can tunnel from source to the your valence band of the source to the conduction band of the channel. And if you apply some more gate voltage, there will be electric field, vertical electric field also increases, and electrons can easily tunnel through this tunnel width. See, this is the in case of the NTFET, what you have to do, applying the gate voltage, pushing the energy band downward in the channel, and resulting in the narrower energy barrier between the source and the channel. And this allows the your whatever the electrons are there in the source to the tunnel through the barrier, the conduction band of the channel. If you apply some positive your drain to source voltage, positive voltage between drain with respect to the gate. And the tunnel fed attributes to low substation swing of below 60 millivolt per decade, and your low leakage current. That means the off current also very low. By controlling the band bending of the channel region using the gate bias, it is possible abruptly to switch on or off the interband tunnel. As you have seen, we can control the gate voltage, and as a result, we can easily turn it on or off the tunnel fed. And the BTBT current depends on the your whatever the tunneling probability TWKB. It depends upon the interband tunneling principle. See, this is the your whatever the tunneling probability that I have told, this transmission probability WKB approximation. See, this is the one derived formula. And this, as you can see, the tunneling probability, it is the function of this parameter. This is the expression. Lambda is the tunnel width, and EG is what? EG is the band gap at the of the semiconductor at the tunnel junction, and delta is the overlap of the valence band and the conduction band in source and the destination site. Q is the charge, M star is effective mass, and the H bar is what? Reduced Planck's constant. See, that means what you can see if you reduce the tunnel width, that means if you reduce this lambda, this tunneling probability also increases. If the tunneling probability increases, that means the on time, that means the device performance also increases. Similarly, we can modulate this energy band also. Whatever the EG is there, this by modulating this energy band, that means by using some low band gap material. If you are using some low band gap material like the germanium or some other semiconductor material, we can improve the your tunneling probability of the tunnel fit. And if we improve the tunneling probability, whatever the tunneling probability is there, it is directly related to the your current. It is directly related by modulating this energy band gap. Then we improve the your device characteristics, that means properties or the current of the tunnel fit. And this is the figure shows that this is the corresponding lambda is the tunnel width or at the on state and the off state operation. See, this is the ITRS requirement of the tunnel fit up to the 2013. As you can see, the tunnel fit, still the research is development is it is underway, and that this is the research. This black color indicates the what the research required. Still, the research is required in case of the tunnel fit. And these are the development underway. This sky color indicates the your development underway, and this indicates that still the research is required in case of the tunnel fit. And continuous improvement is also going on by using the continuous improvement also going on by using the 3-5 or semiconductor or the germanium, that means low band gap semiconductor material. These are the ITRS targets of the on current and the off current. As you can it is seen that if you need the high performance, then this is the ITRS requirement of the off current. Similarly, for low operating power, this is the requirement of the your project. This is the requirement of the for the your off current. Similarly, for the your low standby power, this is the requirement for the your off current. Similarly, this is the requirement for the saturation current for various like the high performance or the low operating power or the low standby, or if you are using the 3-5 or the group, that means low band gap germanium as the channel material. So the same thing is mentioned, the unlike the MOSFET, the gate control tunneling window in the TFET is able effectively filter the high energy carrier in the energy band, and hence leads to substantial sub 60 millivolt per decade strip at room temperature. And in order to achieve the projected energy efficiency, a desired tunneling current at the device on state, a high on to off current, and an average strip access over a few decade of current are the key design factor of the TFET. That means these things you have to remember when you are designing any tunnel FET. You should get the 60 millivolt per decade of substantial swing at room temperature, and the on state, that means on to off current ratio, must be very high in case of the tunnel FET. This is the band to band generation rate. The band to band generation, this is, you can see this is also a function of the energy band gap. By modulating this energy band gap, we can improve the band to band generation rate also in case of the tunnel fit, where this A and the B, these are the constant, and E is the electrical, and EG is the energy band gap at the tunnel junction, which is the main parameter we can modulate. By modulating this energy band gap, we can modulate the your band to band generation of the tunnel fit. See, next the today topic, these are the various why you need the, till now we have discussed what, why you need the tunnel FET or the FinFET, that means the novel devices, or we have also discussed the what is the importance or how you can various design parameter, like in case of the tunnel fit, you have to remember that always you have to get the less than 60 millivolt per decade subthreshold swing or high on top kind ratio. Those are the various design parameter. Those things also we have discussed. So next we'll discuss the variability. See, the variability means what? In the nanometer, technology node, the process variability, it is very significant parameter, very significant. It has very significant impact on the device characteristics. Like the statistical variability, it induces the your leakage current, limits the scaling of the supply voltage, and ultimately it affects the your circuit performance. And the some variability, statistical variability are what? The random dopant fluctuation, or lineage roughness, or metal gate granularity, that means MGG. See, among these, we will discuss this MGG because this is the most dominant one in the advanced MOS technology, CMOS technology. And the metal, see, as you know, the metal, it is conductor. And due to having this high conductivity, we are using this metal as the gate material. Because by using the metal as the gate material, the on-kind also increases. And but when you are using the metal as the gate material, it has the defined work function in defined orientation, and which induce a local variation in threshold voltage within the gate area. This local variation in the work function leads to the fluctuation in the carrier density and the transport of the carrier, which significantly affect the device characteristics. See, the whatever the metal is there, the metal, if you use the titanium metal or the tantalum metal, they have various, they have defined torque function and defined orientation. As you know, the metal, it has some grain also. And depending upon the grain, it has some defined work function and defined orientation. And as a result, it has, as a whole, it will lead to the fluctuation in the various electrical parameter. And we'll discuss in detail this thing. And see, this is one of the one square size grain is there. Normally the square size grain is not practically achievable. However, if you think about the square size grain is there, the total number of grain is simply given by this formula. W and L are the length of the device, and length and width of the device respectively, and G is the grain size of the device. Then at that time, the probability density function and the average value of function is given by these two formula. While N is the what? N is represents the simply total number of grain, and the X1 and the X2 are the random variable which represents the number of grains. See, like this, this is one of the established formula that we have taken from the one reference. See there, but when we plot this one, as you can see, as the number of grain increases, this is for this figure A shows the number of grains for only one grain. However, if you are using the number of grains 16, by using the large number of grain or by increasing the number of grain, the variation in work function reduces. The variation in work function reduces, and the distribution plot also close to normal in case of the what? In case of the your by using the more number of grain. The variation in the work function reduces, and the distribution is close to normal in case of the your more number of grain. See, next we'll discuss such type of analysis in case of the FinFET structure. One such structure we have considered is step FinFET. One such structure we have considered here is your step FinFET. See, in case of the See, one such structure we have considered as the step FinFET. As you can see, we have seen in the literature that if you reduce the pin width by same dimension, suppose if you reduce the pin width, then the on as well as the off coin reduces by same amount. So in order to overcome those barrier, we have used the step-like pin. As you can see, in this case, the pin structure of the FinFET is just like a step. So that on kind as well as the, there will be the improvement in the on off kind also, as well as the on kind also increased by significant amount. See, this is the 2D view of the FinFET structure, and this is the what this is the normal conventional. This figure C shows the conventional kinfish structure. This is in the 2D view of the conventional kinfish structure. See the various dimension we have considered as per the 10 nanometer technology. No. See whatever the work we have done using the ticket simulator. We have done using the ticket simulator. See in this regard, what we have done, we have calibrated the experimental data with the simulator. With the ticket simulator, we have done the calibration. See how, why, what is the means significance of the calibration? See because we have not done the experimental work, but we have extracted the experimental data from reference from the published work, and we have calibrated the various parameters like the mobility parameter or some other parameter also in order to get the proper matching between the your input as well as the output characteristics. As you can see, we have got the proper matching between the experimental and the simulation data in terms of both transfer as well as the output characteristics. See, this calibrated model, whatever the ticket physics calibrated model we got, this model is used for rest of the simulation in order to get the realistic simulation results. See, like this, this is the requirement for the ITRS. This is the requirement for the ITS. As you can see in the technology note 10 nanometer in the year of 2017, the SS requirement is your 70 subthreshold swing. Like the on current is requirement is your 1.567 microampere per micrometer. Like this, your threshold voltage requirement is your millivolt in the, that means 0.336 volt. So this is the requirement in the year of because we have considered the 10 nanometer technology node, that's what we have considered this point. This is the requirement for the this technology node. So like this, as we have seen that the on to off current ratio is improved by significant amount in the order of 10 to the power 10. This red color is the step FinFET and the your black color is the conventional FinFET. This on to off current ratio is in the order of 10 to the power 10 for the step device compared to the conventional devices. However, the SS also improved by significant amount, and it is seen that this is the requirement for the your 10 nanometer technology node. It satisfies the 10 nanometer technology node also, and it is seen that on current there is a small amount of small amount of degradation in the on current. However, the off current is improved by significant amount for step device compared to the conventional devices, compared to the conventional FinFET. Next, we have plotted the electric field. The horizontal electric field is also seen that is less in case of the step device compared to the conventional devices. That means the step device, it has the improved hot care effect compared to the your conventional device because of having the less horizontal electric field. And this is the gate capacitance also less, and due to having the less gate capacitance in terms of the speed also, step device will be favorable compared to the conventional device. And next we have plotted the input ionization rate, and it is seen that input ionization rate is very low in case of the step device compared to the conventional device. That means in case of the hot carrier effect also, step FinFET is acceptable, that means favorable compared to the conventional FinFET. See, next, this is the scaling parameter. Next, what we did, we have done the work function variability in the step device. In this respect, what we did, we have considered the titanium as the gate material, and we have used the random algorithm in order to show the effect of work function variability on the electrical parameter. And we have considered non-uniform distribution of the grain within the gate area with various average grain size. And each structure, for each combination of the structure, we have simulated the structure 200 times. And we have find out the variation in the electrical parameters. See, this table shows the as we have used the titanium as the gate material. From the your reference experimental paper, we have collected this data, and we have seen that the titanium, it has two orientation, 200 and 111, with probability 60 and 40% and work function value of 4.6 and 4.4. And we have considered this parameter, this value in the simulator, in the ticket simulator, and we use the random algorithm to find out the variation in various electrical parameters. So in this respect, you can see the figure 22 shows the top view of the step device. It shows the random distribution of work function of the gate material within the gate area. And this figure shows the ID versus VG characteristics for 200 different device. The symbol represents the nominal value, and the lines are these are the 200 samples. So next, you can see the sigma VT, it represents what? The variation in the threshold voltage. The variation in the threshold voltage reduces as the channel length as well as the channel width increases, because if the channel length and the channel width increases, the number of grain also, that means N increases. And as a result, the variation in the threshold voltage reduces. However, if you are using the large grain size, then by using the large grain size, the number of grain reduces, and due to having less number of grain, the variation in work function degrades. That means it increases in both the case for with the variation in the, as you can see, for both the your figure 24A and the B. That means when you are using the large number of grain, with the variation in work function, variation in the threshold voltage degrade. However, it is seen for grain size, where fiber represents the grain size, for fiber of 15 nanometer, it got almost saturated, because in this case, the number of grain is very limited. Like only for this dimension, only one or two grain may be present. That means the number of grain also saturated. That's what the variation in the threshold voltage also saturated for this grain size of 15 nanometer. Like this, next we have plotted the on kind and the off kind by taking the channel length as the parameter, and it is seen that on kind as well as the off kind also reduces with the increasing the channel length because of the increasing the number of grain. However, as the grain size increases, this your sigma ion and the sigma ion degrade. So this is the distribution plot of threshold voltage on kind and the off kind, and it is seen that as the grain size increases, the distribution also, the variation in the threshold voltage also increases, or the on kind also increases. Similarly, the variation in the off kind also increases. However, when using the less now grain size is very low, then the number of grain is very large, and the distribution at that time, whatever the distribution, it is close to the normal distribution, either for threshold voltage or the on or the off kind. However, it is the bimodal in case of the large grain size. As you can see, this is bimodal in case of the large grain size. However, for small grain size, because of having large number of grain, it is close to the normal distribution. And however, in this case, as you see, in case of the titanium, the work function is 4.4 and 4.6. That means the difference is simply 0.2. That means difference between these two bimodal, it cannot be also greater than 0.2. It will be within the 0.2 only. It is also seen from this threshold voltage plot, distribution plot of the threshold voltage also. So next, we have plotted the sigma VT as a function of the dielectric constant. And it is seen that this C pinpet represents the what? The C pinpet is simply the conventional pinpet, and in case of the C pinpet, whatever the C pinpet is there, in case of the C pinpet, it behaves better. The step pinpet, it behaves better in terms of the variation in the threshold voltage compared to the your conventional pinpet. And however, as the grain size increases, the variation in the threshold voltage increases for both the devices. And as the dielectric constant increases, the variation in the threshold voltage increases because of the increase in the surface potential, as it is seen from figure 27B. As the dielectric constant increases, the surface potential increases, and as a result, the sigma VT also degrades. See, like this, we have plotted the on current and the off current, and in this respect, we have plotted the transfer characteristic also. And it is seen that with the transfer characteristics, as the K increases, on-current increases, and off-current degrade. And in this regard, we have plotted the surface potential at gate voltage 0 and the 1.5 volt. And it is seen that this is due to the increase in the surface potential in case of the gate voltage of at the on state. That means the gate voltage 1.5 volt, the surface potential increases. That's why the on current also increases. However, the for gate voltage 0, as K increases, the surface potential reduces. That's why the on off current reduces. That's what we are getting these characteristics. And again, these characteristics also related to this sigma ion and the sigma IO. Because as you can see, the sigma ion as well as the sigma IO also, sigma ion, it increases with the increasing the K. And this is due to the increasing the surface potential. However, if we are using this in case of the sigma IO, that means the variation in the off current reduces with increasing the dielectric constant. Hello? Is it okay? Am I audible?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. So that's what we are getting the characteristics of the variation in the on current on the off current is like this. However, next we have plotted the variation in the SS. SS means subthreshold swing. The subthreshold swing also, because of having the better gate control, the silicon device has low variation in the subthreshold swing compared to the conventional device. However, with increasing the dielectric constant, the gate controllability over the channel increases. That's why the variation in the subthreshold swing reduces for both the device. And as it is obvious that with the increase in the grain size, the number of grains are very low. That's why the subthreshold swing variation also degrades as the grain size increases from 5 to 7 nanometer. So next, we have plotted the histogram. And histogram plot, as you can see, the histogram plot also shows that the silicon step device shows the better characteristics in terms of the threshold voltage variation compared to this conventional device. However, by using the high K dielectric, that means lanthanum oxide, the variation in the threshold voltage degrades for the, that means increases, that's why it degrades for the your silicon step device compared to the your SiO2 as the dielectric. And this is the SS variation plot, the histogram plot for SS variation. And it is seen that the by using the step device, the variation in the threshold voltage is reduces in case of the step device compared to the conventional FinFET. It is seen, you can check it, this span is less, this variation is less compared to this conventional device. And however, by using the high K dielectric, the gate control increases. That's what the variation in the subthreshold swing also reduces by using the lanthanum as the oxide, gate oxide material compared to the SiO2. Like this, we have plotted the on current and the off current also. And the on current, off current also shows that by using the silicon step device shows the less variation in the on current. And however, by using the high K dielectric, that is lanthanum oxide, the variation in the on current also degrades. The similar case means the conventional device shows variation, more variation in the off current compared to the step device. And by using the lanthanum as the oxide, gate oxide material, this variation reduces. See, the similar analysis we have done for the your germanium step device. So in this case, we have used as germanium as the your channel material. As we know, the germanium, it is the low band gap material. And because nowadays the industry, they are moving to the germanium also. That's what we have done this analysis for the germanium material also. And it is seen that for the germanium material also, it shows the similar behavior. With the increasing the channel length, the variation in the threshold voltage reduces. And similarly, with the increasing the channel width also, the variation in the threshold voltage reduces. However, as the grain size increases, the number of grain reduces. That's why the variation in the threshold voltage degrades. Similarly, the similar behavior is obtained for the on and the off current also. And this is the your histogram, that means distribution plot of the threshold voltage on current and the off current of the germanium device. And the germanium device also shows the similar behavior in like the silicon But in this case, whatever the variation is there, it will be more like the on-kind variation and the off-kind variation. Those will be more because of having the low band gap material. So like this, finally you have compared between the silicon and the germanium material, and it is seen that the silicon device it has the more variation in the threshold voltage compared to the germanium device. See, it is seen for the grain size 5 nanometer even for however when the grain size is 10 nanometer or the 15 nanometer, it is material independent, because for this grain size, the number of grain when it is 5, 10 or the 15 nanometer, the number of grain within the gate area is very limited. That means it got saturated. That's what, whatever may be the material, the variation in the threshold voltage got saturated. See, but however, for low grain size, it is seen that the germanium device is favorable because of having the low variation in the threshold voltage. See, in order to explain it, we have plotted this figure, figure 35B, which shows the surface potential. And in this case, we have divided the channel into three different work functions. The work function near the source and the drain has the value of 4.5 electron volt. And in between this, the work function value is 4.4 electron volt. This dot color, it is for the germanium, red dot, and this black color, solid black, this is for the silicon. And it is seen that the variation in the work function, the variation in the threshold voltage, that means delta VT germanium is 8 millivolt and delta VT silicon is 33 millivolt. This delta VT silicon or the germanium means what? This is the your potential difference between this high work function and the low work function. And it is seen that it is more in case of the germanium compared to the, sorry, it is more in case of the silicon compared to the germanium. See, that's what we got the we have seen that the germanium device, it has less variation in the threshold voltage compared to the silicon, because this potential difference is very low in case of the germanium between this high and the low work function compared to the silicon. Finally, we have plotted the Pellgrom's plot, which is the one popular plot, and it is the plot between the, it is one in the name of one scientist, and this is the plot between the variation in the threshold voltage versus under square root of the effective area. And it is seen that the Pellgrom's plot also shows that the germanium device, it has the less variation, this red color, it has the less variation in the your threshold voltage compared to the silicon. That's what we can expect, that the germanium device, it will be more favorable in terms of the variability compared to the silicon device. Next, we have plotted the another plot, and this is the sigma VT versus RGG. RGG means root square grain, and root square grain means it is the root square grain. It is simply the ratio of the what grain size by square root of the area. Whatever the your device area is there, the RGG means simply the grain size by square root of the area. And in this case, star blue color indicates the experimental data that we have taken from the literature. And this is MC means the Monte Carlo simulation. And this Monte Carlo simulation also we have taken from the literature. And this is our result. This black color our result. And it is seen that for this this experimental data is for this RGG value, this is close to the our simulation data, even the Monte Carlo data also. Similarly, in this case also, Monte Carlo data also shows the better close, this experimental data shows the close matching with the your Monte Carlo data, even with the simulation data. That's what we can expect, that this simulation can also be realistic up to certain extent. See, next, finally, we have designed the, see this, whatever we have discussed, this is the your statistical variability analysis in case of the your FinFET device. And we have considered the step FinFET device in this case. But without the application, the work will be somehow incomplete. In this regard, we have designed the digital inverter, we have designed a digital inverter using the step FinFET, and in this case, this is the digital inverter circuit, and we have designed this using the ticket simulator. This is the P FinFET and this is the N FinFET, and it is the transfer transient characteristics. And here we have considered one is the conventional FinFET, then step FinFET, and then we have considered gallium arsenide as the channel material. And it is seen that, and we have calculated the delay parameter, and it is seen that the step device, it has the low average delay compared to the conventional and the gallium arsenide device. However, the gallium arsenide, it has the highest average delay, because the gallium arsenide, the mobility value is mobility is high, and as a result, your the capacitance also will be high, and due to having the large capacitance, the delay also increases in the case of the your gallium arsenide compared to the your other material, because the gallium arsenide, the dielectric constant also very high. And silicon device, it shows the less intensive delay, that means average delay compared to the other device. Then what we did, we have considered the SIG. Next, what we did, we have in order to show the investigate this inverter performance in more, we have changed the channel source material of the conventional, that means of the step FinFET, and we have considered SIGE as the source material. And as you know, the SIG, it is the mole fraction dependent material. That means it is the mole fraction dependent material. So in this case, what we did, as you can see, we have changed the mole fraction from 0 to 0.6, and as you increase the mole fraction, this on kind of the devices also increases. On kind of the devices also increases, and this is due to reduction in the energy band gap. As you can see, this energy band gap also reduces if you increase the mole fraction. However, the capacitance also increases along with the increase in the mole fraction. See, next, we have designed, as I have told, we have designed the inverter. That's what we have plotted the voltage transfer characteristics and the transient characteristics of this SIG source step FinFET. And this is the transient characteristics, and better characteristics obtained along with the increase in the mole fraction. And from this plot, from this voltage VTC and the transient characteristics, we have estimated this parameter, that means the noise margin and the delay parameter. And this VOS as the high means out at the output side high level voltage. Similarly, this is the low level voltage, and this is the input side high level voltage, and this is the input side high low level voltage. And we have checked, we have seen that this noise margin also increases as the your increases as mole fraction increases by significant amount. Similarly, the low state noise, however, the low state noise margin, it decreases along with the increasing the mole fraction. And if we check the average delay, it degrades with the your state, with the your increasing the mole fraction, because with this increasing the mole fraction, the capacitance, as you have seen, the capacitance also increases, and the as a result, the your whatever the delay is there, it also degrades with the increase in the mole fraction for the step device. So this is all about the your FinFET structure. In the FinFET, what we have studied the variability, work function variability due to metal grain. We have studied the electrical parameters, like the we have studied the only the threshold voltage, then on kind, off kind, and the sub threshold swing. Then we have developed the your digital inverter using the step FinFET, and we have doing some analysis, like the delay parameter we have calculated. Next, we have changed the source material of the step FinFET, and we have calculated the noise margin and the delay parameter. So finally, this is the last topic, the work function variability in the SIGE tunnel FET. So in this case, we have considered SIGE as the channel material. This is the 3D view of the tunnel FET that we have considered, and this is the 2D view of the tunnel FET that we have considered. See, this is the various parameter, the channel length, we have considered three different channel length. Similar width also we have considered, these are the width that we have considered. and height of the channel we have considered 10 nanometer, oxide thickness is 3 nanometer, and these are the various doping that we have considered. The source doping is this one, due to get the less ambipolar current, we have considered high source doping compared to the drain doping, and these are the supply voltage is your 1 volt. This is the simulation specification, like the in case of the FinFET, the same random algorithm that we have used, and we have considered the your non-uniform distribution. Similarly, here also we have considered the titanium as the metal gate, and as you know, it has the two orientation in two different orient with probability 60 and the 40% of work function 4.6 and 4.4 electron volt. And this is the like the FinFET, the same simulation strategy we have considered in case of the tunnel FET also. However, this is the your calibration of the experimental data. As you can see, the calibration also shows the better matching with the experimental data. In the calibration, we have modified the various tunneling parameter also. As you can see, in this case, this symbol represents the experimental data, and this line represents the whatever the calibrated, that means the simulation data, and the better matching is obtained between the simulation and the your experimental data, and this this means physics model is used for rest of the simulation. And figure 44a and the b, this is the transfer characteristics for two different mole fraction of 0.3 and 0.8. as it is seen that as the mole fraction increases, the on-kind also increases. The on-kind in this case 2.02 milliampere, in this case 1.83, and SS value also increases in case of the by increase the mole fraction. And this in this case, this line represents the 200 sample, and the symbol it represents the nominal value, the nominal value of the various data that we have extracted from the simulator. This 200 samples means we have done the simulation by 200 times. See, next this figure 45, it shows the energy versus the your distance plot for three different mole fraction, for two different mole fraction, x equal to 0 and 0.5 and 0.8 and the 1. And it is seen that as the mole fraction increases, this tunnel width also reduces. With the increase in the mole fraction, this tunnel width also reduces. That's what the on-kind also increases. As we go from mole fraction, suppose 0.5 to the 1, the tunnel width also reduces. In this case, 0.5, this is the, if you take the valence band, there is shift in the valence band, and this tunnel width reduces with the increase in the mole fraction. That's what the on-kind also increases. See, next, we have done the statistical variability analysis for this SIG channel tunnel FET, and like the as the mole fraction increases, the what we have seen, the variation in the threshold voltage reduces, and as the grain size increases, the variation in the threshold voltage increases, because as the grain size increases, what happened, which increasing the grain size, the number of grain reduces. That's what the variation in the threshold voltage increases. However, as the mole fraction increases, the for various values of grain size, it is seen that the variation in the threshold voltage reduces, because x increases means what? X increases means the semiconductor capacitance also increases, and due to increase in the semiconductor capacitance, what happened? The variation in the threshold voltage also reduces. The due to increase in the semiconductor capacitance, the variation in the threshold voltage also reduces. That's why this sigma VT reduces when x changes from this suppose 0.4 to the 1. And as you have seen, the as the mole gain size increases from 5 to 15 nanometer, the sigma VT increases, and it can be explained from this energy band diagram. In this regard, we have plotted the fluctuation in energy band diagram for 10 samples, and for three different grain size, this figure 47a is for 5 nanometer grain size, b is for 10 nanometer, similarly figure 47c is for 15 nanometer band size. And it is seen that as the grain size increases, the changes in the energy band gap also increases. That means the fluctuation in the energy band gap also increases between increases in case of the your 15 nanometer grain size compared to the 5 nanometer grain size. And due to this increase in the fluctuation of the energy band gap, the variation in the threshold voltage also increases by significant amount, as seen from the figure 47 A, B, and C. See, like this, like the your FinFET. Next, we have plotted the distribution plot of this threshold voltage for three different gain sets, 5, 10, and the 15. Sorry, this one is 15 nanometer, 5, 10, and the 15 nanometer. And it is seen that as the grain size in as the mole fraction increases, the variation in the threshold voltage reduces. And as the grain size increases, as you can see from here to here, the variation in the threshold voltage increases by significant amount. Finally, we have plotted the sigma. We have shown the variation in the threshold voltage by for varying grain size at x equal to 1 for gate length by taking the gate length as the parameter and the channel width as the parameter. And it is seen that you can observe from this figure 49A that as the channel length increases, the variation in threshold voltage, that means sigma Vt, the changes in the sigma Vt is very negligible. It is very negligible for defined gain size, for that means gain size 5, 10 or the 15 nanometer. However, from 49B, it is seen that the variation in the threshold voltage reduces, as the channel width increases. From 10 to 20 nanometer. See why it happens, because as you know, the tunnel FET operation, it depends upon the your tunnel width. The operation of the tunnel FET mainly depends upon the channel width, not the channel length. That's what, along with the variation in the channel length, the changes in the sigma Vt is very negligible. However, as the grain size increases, as we know, n equal to your simply WL by G square. As the grain size increases, the number of grain, that means this n, reduces. That's what the sigma Vt increases. And as the your channel width increases, we know the this n also increases. That's what it has a significant impact on the variability in the threshold voltage. That means channel, as the channel increases, the sigma Vt reduces. However, as the grain size, that means your this G or the this fiber increases, the number of grain, that means n, reduces. That's what, like this variation in the channel length with as the grain size increases from 5 to 15 nanometer, the sigma Vt also degrade, that means increases by significant amount. Okay, see, this is all about the your variation in the your variability in the various, only have means reported the variability in the threshold voltage for this SIG channel tunnel FET. And this is all about the your variability analysis in the tunnel FET. So next, from the conclusion, what we have seen, we have seen that whatever the step device that we have considered, the step device. First, we have seen that electrical parameters, that means whether it satisfies the ITRS technology requirement or not. And for this, we have considered the dimension for 10 nanometer technology node. And it is seen that the step device, it satisfies the ITRS requirement of the on to off current ratio. Whatever the current we got, that is in the order of 10 to the power 10. That means it satisfies the ITRS requirement of the on current and the off current. And we have, because ITRS requirement, we should satisfy the whatever the device that we have proposed, it should satisfy the ITRS requirement. And it is seen that the on to off current is the order of 10 to the power 10. That's what we can expect. This is also satisfy the ITRS requirement. Even the SS value that we have got, that is 67 point something 5 millivolt per decade, and the ITRS requirement for 10 nanometer node is 70 millivolt per decade. That's what we can expect, the whatever the step device that is acceptable from the ITRS, that means from industrial point of view also. Then the whatever the variability analysis we have done, and we have seen that the variability, from the variability analysis, the sigma VT, that means the variation in the threshold voltage, that means variation in the threshold voltage, it also reduces along with the channel length as well as the channel width. The whatever the variability analysis that we have reported, it reduces along with the channel length and the channel width because of the increasing the number of grain. Similarly, the your sigma ion, that means the variability in the on current, and the sigma I of variability in the off current, it also decreases as the device dimension increases. And however, as the grain size increases, what you have seen, as the grain size increases, the number of grain within the gate area reduces. That's why your variability in the electrical parameter decreases. Then we have also seen the, we have done the analysis along with the changes in the dielectric constant, and it is seen that sigma VT changes insignificantly with the dielectric constant. However, the sigma SS is very significant. The changes in the your subthreshold swing is very significant with the dielectric constant, because as the dielectric constant increases, the gate control over the channel improves. That's what your the variation in the sigma SS also reduces with the dielectric constant. And it is also seen that the distribution of electrical parameter is close to norm, is close to normal for small grain size. Whenever the small grain, that means the grain size is 2 nanometer or the 5 nanometer, the, your distribution is close to normal distribution. However, for large grain size, that means 10 or 15 nanometer, the distribution is close to the your binomial distribution that you have seen from the simulation analysis. Then the it is also then what we have seen, the similar analysis we have done for the your germanium material also, and it is seen that the germanium device, it has the less variation in the threshold voltage compared to the silicon step FinFET. We have examined by using some potential plot also, one potential plot where we have divided the channel into three different work functions, and it is seen that the difference in work function, difference in your potential between low to high work function is low using the germanium device compared to the silicon device. That's why the germanium step device has less variation in the threshold voltage compared to silicon. And finally, we have seen that complementary step FinFET has lesser intensive delay than compared to the your silicon or the, that is, conventional or gallium arsenide based FinFET. And then next we have plotted the tunnel FET analysis. That means we have considered the SIG channel as the tunnel FET, and we have done the statistical variability analysis. And it is seen that as the mole fraction increases, the variation in the your threshold voltage also reduces. As the mole fraction increases in the tunnel FET, the variation in the threshold voltage reduces. Then sigma VT increases by significant amount with increase in the average grain. See, the as you have seen, the number of as the sigma VT increases, that means sigma VT increases by significant amount with increase in the your average grain. Because as the average grain increases, the number of grain within the gate area also increases. And also we have plotted the energy band diagram. We have seen that the fluctuation in energy band gap also increases by using the large grain size. That's what sigma VT degrade. Then sigma VT, we have seen that sigma VT decreases with increased channel width, while such variation is insignificant with gate length. Because that I have already discussed that, because the tunnel FET operation depends upon mainly the width of the device. That's what, with the increase in the width of the channel, the sigma VT improves. However, along with the variation in the your gate length, the changes in the sigma VT is very negligible. Okay, see, this is all about the that we have discussed in today lecture. Then in the future work, you can note down the statistical variability analysis that we have done for what your that we have done in fin phase structure, similarly for the tunnel phase structure also. You can do some other non-conventional structure also, like the gate all around fin plate or the tunnel plate. Similarly, you can consider the gate modulated tippet also, and you can measure some comparative study. Like the in the fin plate structure, like pie gate structure also, those not reported. Similarly, the gate all around structure also you can consider, and you can make some comparative study. See, the whatever the results or whatever the analysis that we have presented in this today lecture, that is all based on the simulation. The analytical analyze, that means analytical model that is not yet reported, that for statistical variability, that is that means we have not reported the analytical estimation of this electrical parameter due to work function variability of the metal gate. That means this analytical estimation of the electrical parameters this is also one of the important research topic. Then realization of the logic gate and the your RAM circuit. See, whatever the analysis that we have done, whatever the parameter that we have considered only the threshold voltage. That means the DC parameter we have considered. DC means the threshold voltage or on current, off current, or the your sub threshold swing. But still not, we have not considered what? We have not considered the your other device, other parameter, like the your RF parameter or the analog parameter, like how it will have the impact on the your transconductance or the your cutoff frequency or the gate capacitance. Similarly, how it will impact, it has the impact on the your circuit parameter, like the we have not designed the logic gate or the inverter circuit or the RAM circuit, or if we do the such type analysis in this type of circuit analysis, then it will be helpful, or it will be one of the important research topic. You can carry out some research by that means by designing this logic gate or the RAM circuit, or you can do some analysis on the RF parameter or the analog parameter, or some linearity parameter also, like the VIP2, voltage intercept 0.2, or voltage intercept 0.3, or many more like that. Finally, another research topic that you can carry in this work function variability. See, the ferroelectric FET or the ferroelectric fin plate or the tunnel plate. See, the ferroelectric, that means the negative capacitance which boosts the performance of the tunnel plate or boosts the performance of the FET. This has type of statistical variability analysis. That means how it will impact the your electrical parameters like this DC or RF or circuit or linearity parameter or the analog parameter. In case of the ferroelectric fin plate, that means negative capacitance based FET, that is also one of the research important, that is also one of the emerging research area that you can carry out. So these are the various research area that you can carry out in your research work or in your thesis. See, this is all about the today lecture. These are the few references that you have considered in order to carry out, in order to prepare this means presentation or carry out this work. Okay, this is some references. Then thank you all. Thank you, Stacey. If you have any query, you can ask me now. Hello.
Thank you, Dr. Yes. Rajesh Shah, for the nice presentation and enlightening the student participants regarding the effect fin pet different analysis, including the variability of the set one work function and the statistical analysis also. Now if the participants, do you have any question, you can ask directly by unmuting yourself, or else you can mention in the chat box also. Dr. Rajesh, we have one question in the chat box, if you can go through directly.
Yes. Can we be able to implement bio fin plate like bio tippet as a future scope? See, the bio fin plate, see, the even the bio fin plate you can implement, but see, the your bio fin plate, again, the your bio means again it will what it you have to means calculate the sensitivity of the device. But the biofinFET, again, if we implement it, see the FinFET, it is again the 3D structure. Okay, the it is the 3D structure. If you like the your gate dielectric modulated biofet, that means the biosensor FinFET, if you implement, again from the fabrication point of view, it is very means tedious to fabricate the biofinFET. But if you design the tunnel FET based bio means bio tunnel FET, that is be more acceptable from industrial point of view. That's what even if you go through the literature also, you may hardly got one or two paper on the this biosensor based FinFET, but you will get more paper on the bio means biosensor based tunnel FET, because the tunnel FET in case of the biosensor also you can easily design it, even you can easily fabricate also, but bio FinFET is very tedious to fabricate. And again the tunnel FET, as you have seen the tunnel FET, the sensitivity also very high. Even the it has the very very fast switching operation compared to the FinFET. That's what in future, as a future scope, you can design it, but from application or from experimental point of view, it is not, it cannot be acceptable. Have you got it, Amit Bhattacharya? Any other question, any participant?
If participants have any other question, please ask. Another question we have, the structure of TFET as vertical or lateral?
See, it is the lateral, because you can see in this case only the your horizontal tunneling is there. Okay, we have not considered any vertical, only like the normal conventional tunnel phase structure only. Only the whatever the structure we have considered, we have changed only the your channel material, that's it. And beyond that, we have not changed anything. This is the your horizontal TFET only, like the conventional TFET only. I think you got it, Subhangi section.
Any more question from the participants? And I'm again requesting all the participants to fill up the feedback form, because it will make you eligible for the certificate.
Okay, another question came, I think. See, the Migendra, yes, is there any limit how much we can scale down the TFET or not? As there is no short channel effect. It's not like that there is no short channel effect even in the tunnel effect also. See, there is some limitation will be there. Again, the research is also going on. That's what even in the conventional tunnel effect, there is some limitation, like the on current is very low. In order to overcome those on that means those whatever the limitation, the various, like the as I told, that you can do the band gap engineering, structural engineering, or the channel engineering, or the material engineering, various thing you can do. Even in the like the conventional tunnel phase, there is some limitation. That's what people are doing, some structure modifying the structure, or they are proposing like the vertical tunnel phase or some other structure, or they are doing some your channel engineering, like the they are using the channel material group 3-5 semiconductor and etc. like that. Okay, you cannot say you can scale down like the channel length 1 nanometer. You cannot do like that. Okay, there is some limitation also. And Surabhi, you have asked some question. What will be the difference for vertical TFET? See, the vertical TFET means what? There will be the vertical tunneling also will be there. Along with the horizontal tunneling, there will be some vertical tunneling also will be there. See, due to having those vertical tunneling, what happened? The tunneling probability increases. And due to increasing the tunneling probability, the on current, that means the device characteristic also improves. Along with the horizontal tunneling, that means along with this lateral one, the vertical also will be there. That's why the device characteristics also will be increased. That is the advantage of the vertical tunneling. Is any work proposed or simulated on flexible TFET sorry asking for sorry yes I am
I
not
mean,
getting your
asking
question.
for flexible pin pad. Is there any work proposed for flexible pin pad? And is there, I think she want to ask about flexibility of devices, flexible electronics use of the pin pad.
See the yes, you can carry out some work on the flexible pinpet also, but still you have to go through the literature because what type of work is going on. Even I don't have any idea on this flexible pinpet. Means you have to go to the literature. If there is some new work scheme or some I think some novel work came, you can go through the literature. But for the time being, I cannot suggest any work, what type of work you can do on the flexible pin pad. Okay, Ananda. Participant, okay. Generally, how much is the sensitivity in the tunnel plate? See, the sensitivity in the tunnel plate is what? Again, the sensitivity, there is lots of research is going on to improve the sensitivity in the tunnel plate. Again, for the vertical tunnel plate, the Dehnkind sensitivity, it is as I have seen in some paper, it is in the order of 10 to the power 6 or 10 to the power 7 like that. The recently, the some work is going on. As from the recent literature, I have seen, it is in the order of 10 to the power 6 to 10 to the power 7. That's what the lots of research also going on to improve the sensitivity of the tunnel plate also. Okay, generally how much means the because already 10 to the 6 and 7 is reported, that's what you have to improve it more so that it will be acceptable. Okay, I think you got it, Bitra. Any other question? Any participant? Hello.
I think we'll wait for further 1 or 2 minutes for participants to post their question,
Okay, no issue.
then we'll close the session for today. In the meantime, I will request you to please present you the first slide. Let me take a screenshot of that.
Okay, is it visible?
Yeah, make it a presentation mode. I think we have one more question.
See, why do we use rest get defect? See, again, I told that, as I have told that, to improve the like the tunnel plate, the main disadvantage of the tunnel plate is the low on current. That's what, in order to means improve the on current of the your tunnel plate, in order to improve the on current of the tunnel plate, we have to use some your means the gate engineering or the structure or material engineering. In order to improve this on current only, that means you have to reduce the tunnel width. Where people are also proposing, that means the research that they have proposed the rest gate tunnel plate also. That is the means, as I told, those are the all because all the device, whatever we have proposed, there is some limitation also. Of course, there is some advantage, but along with that, some limitation also there. And in order to overcome those limitation, we can use this means we can do some engineering technique to improve the device performance. See the does the rest gate have vertical as well as the lateral tunneling. Rest gate. See the rest gate means yeah, what you are asking, it has the vertical as well as the lateral tunneling.
I think he is asking about the TFET, I think.
No, he's asked Migendra, what is your question? Can you repeat it?
You can unmute yourself and directly speak in the meeting, no problem.
Sir, the raised in raised gate tunneling, raised gate TFAT, do we have a lateral as well as a vertical tunneling, or just vertical tunneling is there?
No, no, both the tunnelings are there in the raised gate. See, in the raised gate, your both the lateral as well as the vertical tunneling will be there. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Any other questions from participants? I think all the questions have successfully answered by our expert speaker, Dr. Rajesh Shah. So if we don't have any questions, then okay, we'll send the second form question form again. Okay, now it is there. Second session feedback form. Okay, everyone do fill a feedback form. So now we are closing the our second session of day one. Thank you, Dr. Rajesh Shah, for your nice presentation and accepting our invitation to present a present the lecture on the topic of big fat and TFAT. And tomorrow, thank you, Rajesh Shah. And tomorrow, we'll start
thank you.
Strategies in FinFET. After that, we have the emerging FETs for the analog RF circuit that will be presented by Sunil Pandey, analog design engineer, Intel Corporation. And after that, modeling approaches in TFET. So that will be presented by Dr. Suman Kumar Mitra from myself. So tomorrow the sessions will be start from 10 a.m. and first lecture will be for 1 hour, 10 to 11 a.m. and we'll have 1 5-minute short break. Then we'll start the again from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Then we have two hours break, and then we'll start the session from 2 to 3 for the modeling and approaches, and 3 to 4 we have the hands-on demonstration session where we'll start the familiarization of Synopsys TCAD tool. So all the participants are requested to join the tomorrow session at sharply 9:50 a.m. as the session will start from the 10 a.m. onwards on the modeling strategies in FinFET. Thank you everyone, all the participants, for the present for your kind presence in the session day one, and do fill up the feedback form before leaving the meeting. And thank you, Dr. Rajesh Shah, once again. And
thank you, Dr. Suman.
One lecture tomorrow also. So we'll eager to listen from you from on tomorrow again.
Okay, thank you. Thank you all.
And please submit the feedback form, everyone.